Hey everybody, it's part two of the Monday Q&A, so let's get it done. What is your opinion on padding the bar for squats? Padding the bar, I'm assuming people mean putting the pads on the bar or wrapping a towel around it. I am not a fan of this for multiple reasons. One, you're not learning how to squat correctly with it because you're not learning how to seat the bar correctly. Two, it gives you a more unstable environment. The bar can shift easier because it's not set in tightly like it should be. You have to learn to set the bar correctly on your back, either into your traps or between your traps and your rear delts, depending on high bar or low bar, but it's not as secure, and therefore it is going to reduce your stability on the squat, and it's going to reduce the amount of weight you can use because you're going to have issues with the weight shifting too much up top. It's just less stable, so it's going to give you less weight that you can use on any given set, so therefore you're going to get less development from it in terms of your lower body, which is usually your primary focus in your squats, and with all the muscles in the upper body being your secondary concern as far as doing it for hypertrophy purposes or development purposes. But when it comes to the overall strength, you're simply using a lighter weight all the time because of that. What people need to learn to do is how to set the bar correctly. And if they don't have the proper shelf and rear delt development and things like that to set the bar in correctly, they need to spend some extra time building those muscles up so that they can do so. If squatting is painful for you and you've been squatting a little while, generally it's because people haven't developed a proper callus there in that area to keep it from hurting the skin. But if they've been training a little while, if you've been squatting a couple months and you still can't squat heavy without some sort of padding on the bar, you don't know how to squat. It's an issue if you need to learn how to get set in tight. You're not set up tight enough, you don't have your scapula pulled back enough, and you don't have the bar set in the correct spot. You need to learn how to squat correctly, and that will resolve the issue. Okay, next question. Does controlling the negative longer mean you build more muscle? I've heard that it's proven to build more muscle, so why don't a lot of people take advantage of this? Why is it so underrated? Okay, this is one of those bro myths that isn't true. It isn't proven that slow eccentrics build more muscle. All the evidence we've had from the past 15 or 20 years say that a slow negative versus just a fairly controlled negative doesn't produce any more hypertrophy, but having some control over the negative produces more hypertrophy than if you skip the negative completely. Meaning if you just drop the bar on your chest with a bench press and then you relift it again, or you drop the bar every time on your deadlift and only do the concentric rep, we do have research showing that you will get less hypertrophy. So when we say that the eccentrics contribute massively to hypertrophy and seem to contribute potentially more than the concentric, we just mean that you're doing an eccentric rep and that you have some control, that you're not just letting the bar drop uncontrolled. And there is a lot of data on that, but when they've tested the timing of it, a 4-second negative doesn't produce any more hypertrophy than a 1-second negative. And even more interesting, and I don't have it handy, you people can research yourself. I saw a few weeks ago a study that is seeming to find even the opposite of that, that a very fast negative to where you just maintain control on the very bottom so that you have a very rapid deceleration at the bottom so that you're controlled there, actually seems to produce a little more hypertrophy than even the more controlled negative does. So there is evidence emerging in the other direction that a very fast negative to where you're just decelerating the most at the bottom so that it's not a true non-eccentric rep may very well have more potential for hypertrophy. And it makes sense when you look at the mechanical tension and the leverages involved in that deceleration. All right, last question. What is your take on joint support supplements? Do they work? And if so, what would you recommend? To my knowledge, we don't have scientific evidence showing that any joint support supplements actually work. If you're having problems with your joints from training, your training programming is bad, or your execution of lifts is bad, or your exercise selection is bad. You have some sort of imbalance in your program and something needs to be addressed, because correct strength training and correct resistance training is the best thing you can possibly do for your joints that we have ever found. That is your joint support supplement, is correct training with correct deloads, with correct muscle balance and correct technique. That is worth 100 times more than any supplement that has ever been invented for it, because we don't even have evidence that the supplements work for this, but we know that the training does. And if you're still having joint issues outside of that, you're possibly dehydrated, not getting enough water, or your diet is just too excessively low in fat, particularly essential fats. So maybe an omega-3 supplement would benefit you at that point. All right, guys, that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it has been informative, and I will talk to you next time.